So life is short. Life is short.
人生苦短，生命短暂。
I work in a hospital as a pharmacist, and you know I've seen it many times.
我在工作，我的工作就是在医院里面做药剂师。我见过这种场景太多次了。
And you know there's a ward in a hospital. They basically they deals especially with people with cancer.
那医院里面有一个区域呢，是专门收治这些患癌症的。
And these patients have to go through chemotherapy, and you know it's a very sad ward to be.
那他们都要在那里接受化疗，所以那个地方呢就是一个充满悲伤的地方。
And you see their family around them, and watching their loved one going through the pain and suffering, and they're just wondering how much longer they might have with them.
我们可以看到他们的家人呢围绕在他们的身边陪伴。看着他们所爱的人经历这些痛苦和折磨，而且他们也在想，他们究竟还能陪家人多久呢
？And you know, one of my friends, her four-year-old son just suddenly just got a leukemia this week, and he passed away on Friday, and he was just 4 years old.
我有一个朋友，他的儿子才四岁，然后最近他不幸的患上了。血癌，然后才四岁，对，就走掉了。
And death is staring right in their face, and their world just suddenly just gone dark.
那死亡呢，正在盯着他们的脸，他们的世界呢，突然变得一片黑暗。
Now some of you probably don't even think about death at the moment.
大家现在可能根本就不会去想关于死亡的事情。
You know, we're busy with our lives, we're busy with our work and our family.
我们都在忙于生活，忙着工作，然后在忙于陪伴家人。
We have all these big plans that we want to do for our life.
那我们对我们的生活有很多这些宏伟的计划。
We have holidays to go to, we have new experiences to have.
那我们要去度假，我们要去经历一些新的体验。
What if I tell you right now that you only have 1 week left to live?
那想象一下，如果我现在告诉大家，你的生命只剩下最后一个星期了，你会怎么办呢
？What would you do?
你会做些什么事情呢
？Would you go? I'm just gonna stay home and do nothing, or I'm just gonna wait for death to come?
那你会不会就这样待在家里，什么事情都不做，然后等死呢？
Or do you go, I'm going to make the most of every moment until I die?
还是你会充分利用剩下的每一分钟直到死去呢
I think all of us try to make the most of everything, right?
我想大部分人都会尽力充分利用每一分每一秒，对吗
And throughout my last two talks on Ecclesiastes, I've repeated many times that we should enjoy the moment.Make the most of your moments right now, and see what you have as a gift from God.
那我回想在之前的两次讲道当中，那我已经重复很多次了。我们应该享受当下，充分利用当下，把拥有的一切当作是从神而来的恩赐。
Don't try to gain or try to control your future, but try just to find satisfaction in your life right now.Because the reality is nothing lasts.
那不要试图获得或者是去控制你的未来，而是现在就在你的生活中找到满足感，因为现实就是没有什么是永恒的。
Your clothes, your shoes, your body, your knowledge, your life—they are like a mist here for a moment, and then they're gone the next.
我们的衣服、我们的鞋子、身体。脑子里面的知识和我们的生活，就像一团虚空的迷雾，此刻在这里，下一刻就消失了。
My question for us today is, how can we truly find satisfaction in this life in light of death?
那我今天向大家提出的问题就是，面对死亡，我们如何真正找到今生的满足呢？
The teacher is going to answer that for us today in the passage.
那传道者在今天的经文当中呢，就会为我们解答这个问题。
And firstly, he says, we have to remember our Creator.
那第一点他说的就是当记住造我们的主。
And he says in verse 7, light is sweet, and it pleases the eyes to see the sun.
在第七节中说，光本是佳美的。眼见日光也是可悦。
And you know, now it's winter time, but isn't it nice that we get to see the sunlight today?
那现在是冬天，但是当我们看到阳光的时候，我们还是会很开心，对吗？
That warm embrace from the sun on our skin feels good.
那阳光照在我们皮肤上，那种温暖的感觉很好，不是吗？
And the teacher is calling us to enjoy the good things in life.
传道者就鼓励我们去享受生活当中的一切美好。
And he says in verse 8, however many years anyone may live, let them enjoy them all.
第八节说，人活多年就当快乐多年。
Enjoy as much as you can. Make the most of every moment that God has given you under the sun.
我们要尽可能的去享受神的恩赐。充分利用这个神在日光之下的生命当中赐给我们的每一刻。
And verse 9, he says, "You who are young, be happy while you are young, and let your hearts give you joy in the days of your youth. Follow the ways of your heart and whatever your eyes see."
那第九节说，少年人啊，你在幼年时当快乐。在幼年的日子，使你的心欢畅。
So enjoy as much as you can, especially while you're young.
那尤其是在你年轻的时候，要尽可能多的去享受。
Now some of you might be sitting here and think, "Oh, you know, I'm getting old."
那在座的可能有些人会觉得自己已经老了。
Well, if you think you're old, there's always someone older than you.
那如果你认为自己年纪很大，那么总是会有其他人比你的年纪还要大。
You are young compared to that person.
那与那个人相比呢，你还是很年轻的。
And teacher says, follow the ways of your heart and whatever your eyes see.
那传道者说，行你心所愿行的，看你眼所爱看的。
So he said, look for the things and find the things that will bring you joy, happiness, and satisfaction.
那这就是说。要去寻找和发掘能带给你快乐、幸福和满足的事物。
Now, whether it's that coffee from your favorite cafe,
无论是你去这个最喜欢的咖啡馆里面喝咖啡
，or Chinese tea, from your pantry, the teacher says enjoy them.
还是说你在储藏室里边有这个很好的中国的茶叶，你要去享受。
Whether it's that friendship that you have at church,
无论是你在教会里面的友谊
or the family that you belong to, enjoy them.
还是你所属的这个大家庭里面，都要去享受它
or whether it's the work that you do during your week,
那无论是你平日所做的这些工作
or the road trip that you have over the long weekends, enjoy them.
还是你周末的公路旅行都要去享受它们。
And verse 10, the teacher says, "So then, banish anxiety from your heart, and cast off the troubles of your body."
第十节说，所以你当从心中除掉愁烦，从肉体克去邪恶。
Don't be anxious, be trouble-free. Don't worry, be happy.
不焦虑，不烦恼，别担心，开心就好。
And all of these are good, provided that you remember all of these are given by God, the our generous Creator.
这一切都是美好的，前提是你记得这一切都是慷慨的造物主神所赐予的。
Chapter 12, verse 1, it says, "Remember your Creator in the days of your youth."
第十二章一节说，你趁着年幼 当纪念造你的主。
And throughout the book of Ecclesiastes, the teacher keeps repeating this. You know, everything is meaningless or everything is misty, and yet we can find satisfaction in life if we know that each day and every moment is a gift from God.
在整本传道书当中，传道者不断重复，一切都是虚空，一切都是虚空。但是这一切虽然像迷雾一样，如果我们知道每一天。每一刻都是神的恩赐的话呢，你就仍然能在生活当中找到满足。
And our God is a God who provides us all these moments and experiences.
正是我们的神为我们提供了这些时刻和经历。
But often we treat these experiences as if they are God.
但是我们常常会把这些经历的东西当作神。
And I can't live without my phones.
那比如说没有手机，我就活不下去了。
I need to check my Facebook or emails every 5 minutes.
那我需要每5分钟就要查看一次脸书或者电子邮件。
I need that boyfriend, girlfriend experience.
那我需要有这种谈恋爱的体验。
I need to earn lots of money.
我需要挣很多的钱。
I need people to approve me.
我需要他人的称赞。
And don't get me wrong, these things, phone, social media, relationship, personal approval, they're not bad things.
那请不要误会我的意思。手机、社交媒体、感情、钱和认可都不是坏东西。
They are all good things, but the problem is we forget that these things are not God.But that they are just experiences and gifts from God.
他们都很好，问题是我们忘记了这些东西本身不是神，而是神赐给我们的礼物和体验。
And when we turn these things into God, you will realize that they will not bring the satisfaction that you think you get from them.
那当我们把这些东西当作神时，我们就会意识到他们不会带给我们。我们以为能从他们身上得到的那些满足感。
And even if you do get some satisfaction from it at the start, they don't last, they're like a mist.
那即使你一开始能从这些东西当中得到一些满足，但是他们却不是持久的，就像雾一样。
And that sounds a bit sad and hopeless, but it does mean that we don't need to spend all of our energy trying to gain these things.Or experiences, but instead we can just enjoy them what they are, a gift from God.
这听起来有点悲伤或绝望，但这确实意味着我们不需要花费我们所有的精力来尝试获得这些东西或体验，而是我们可以享受他们本来的样子，是从神而来的恩赐。
And when we do that, it will allow us to live a more joyful and fulfilled life.
当我们这样做的时候呢，它实际上会让我们过上更快乐和充实的生活。
So remember your Creator while you are young.
你趁着年幼，当记住造你的主。
And we need to actively remember that each day because we are just so prone to forget.
我们每天都要操练去记住这一点，因为我们很容易就会忘记。
I think one way that's helpful to remember that these things are not God is just to be thankful each day.
我认为有一种方法可以帮助我们记住这些来自于神的恩赐，那就是每天感恩。
You can either write it down on your journey, you know, 3 things I want to thank God for today, or you can pray.
那你可以尝试把它们写在你的日记本上，今天我要感谢神的3件事。或者你可以祷告。
And thank you God for our friends.
感谢神赐给我们朋友。
Thank you God for the sun today.
感谢神今天赐给我们的阳光。
Thank you God for the food.
感谢神赐给我们食物。
And thank you God for being generous to us.
感谢神对我们的慷慨。
And when you start doing that, you will find that not only you enjoy your life more, but that you also enjoy God.
那当你开始这样做的时候，你会发现， 你不仅仅更加能够享受生活，而且能更享受神。
One reason he calls us to remember our Creator while we are young is because life is short and death is a reality for all of us.
那传道者呼吁我们在年幼时记住造我们的主的原因之一，是因为生命短暂，死亡对我们所有人来说都是现实。
So let's read from verse 8 again. However many years anyone may live, let them enjoy them all, but let them remember the days of darkness, for there will be many, and everything to come is meaningless.
那让我们再看一下第八节的内容。人活多年，就当快乐多年。然而也当想到黑暗的日子，因为这日子必多，所要来的都是虚空。
And in verse 10, he says, So then, banish anxiety from your heart, and cast off the troubles of your body, for youth and vigor are meaningless.
第十节说，所以你当从心中除掉愁烦，从肉体克去邪恶，因为一生的开端和幼年之时都是虚空的。
And verse 12, he says, Remember your Creator in the days of your youth.Before the days of trouble come and the years approach, when you will say, I find no pleasure in them, before the sun and the light and the moon and the stars grow dark and the clouds return after the rain.
第十二章一节说，你趁着年幼衰败的日子尚未来到，就是你所说我毫无喜乐的那些年日未曾临近之先。当纪念葬你的主，不要等到日头、光明、月亮、星宿变为黑暗，雨后云彩返回。
So finding satisfaction in this life is really important for the teachers of Ecclesiastes because it knows that one day we will all die.
那对于传道书中的传道者来说，在今生找到满足确实很重要，因为他知道有一天我们都会死。
And when you're dead, you can't really enjoy life anymore.
当你死了之后，就无法再享受生活了。
And he wants us to be honest about that, that the shortness of life is very real.
他希望我们诚实地面对这一点，生命的短暂是非常真实的。
And in verse 3 to 7, he gives us a poem about what it's like to grow old and die.
第三到第七节中，他给了我们一首关于变老和死亡的这样一首诗。
Verse 3, it says, When the keepers of the house tremble.
第三节，看守房屋的发颤。
And it says, it's a metaphor for your arms and your hands that start to tremble. It's like an old person shake.
那他是在比喻一个人老的时候，他的胳膊和手都开始颤抖了，就像我们看到这些老人家颤抖一样。
And then he says, and the strong man stood.
然后他说，有力的屈身。
In other words, your legs, your knees, your shoulders, they start to weaken, and you walking, you bending over while you walking as well.
那这就是在说我们的腿、膝盖、肩膀，这些。地方都开始变得没有力量了，走路时也弯着腰。
When the grinders cease because they are few,
推磨的稀少就止息。
And it's talking about your teeth, you start to lose your teeth.
这就在比喻我们开始掉牙了。
And those looking through the windows grow dim.
从窗户往外看的都昏暗。
It's talking about you can't see that well anymore.
这是在比喻我们的视力没有那么好了。
And then verse 4, it says, When the doors to the street are closed.
第四节说，街门关闭。
So it's either talking about your hearing starts to fail, or you start to close your mouth because you lost all your teeth. You can't open it properly.
这就是在比喻听力开始下降，或者 因为我们的牙都掉了，而嘴巴开始闭上。
And the sound of grinding fades.
推磨的声响微小。
You can't chew your food properly anymore because you lost your teeth.
那就是在说我们不能再嚼食物，因为牙都没了。
And when people rise up at the sound of birds,
雀鸟一叫，人就起来。
You wake up with the birds every morning and you wish that you could sleep a bit longer.
那每天早晨，你一听到这个鸟叫就醒来了，你并且希望说我如果能多睡一会儿多好啊。
And but all the songs grow faint.
那唱歌的女子也都衰微。
You can't speak as loud as before anymore.
这就是在说你不能再像以前那样大声的说话。
And verse 5, when people are afraid of heights and of dangers in the streets.
第五节说，人怕高处，路上有惊慌。
And you become terrified of heights and afraid of falling over even when you are walking down the streets.
那就是说你走路的时候你非常的这个恐高，并且怕时刻都害怕跌倒。
And when the almond tree blossoms,
杏树开花
So you start to have like white hair like the almond blossom.
那我们就开始有这个像杏花开放一般的这样的白发。
And the grasshopper drags itself along.
蚱蜢成为重担。
And if you think of grasshopper, they're pretty agile and fast, right? But not when you're old, you just drag yourself along.
那如果我们想到蚱蜢或者是蚂蚱，它们非常敏捷，而且跳得很快。那可是当我们老了，我们就只能拖着自己的身体往前走。
And desire no longer is stirred.
人所愿的也都废掉。
So you lose your appetite or your sexual desire.
这就是在说我们慢慢失去了食欲和性欲。
And it goes on and says that people go to the eternal home and mourners go about the street. Remember him before the silver cord is severed and the golden bowl is broken, before the pitcher is shattered at the spring and the wheel broken at the well, and the dust returns to the ground it came from, and the spirit returns to God who gave it.
那接下来经文说，因为人归他永远的家。吊丧的在街上往来，银链折断，金冠破裂，瓶子在泉旁损坏，水轮在井口破裂，尘土仍归于地，灵仍归于赐灵的神。
So saying in the end, everything just stops working. Your heart stops beating, your blood stops circulating, and death has come.
那最终一切都会停止运转，心脏停止跳动，血液停止循环，那死亡呢也就临近了。
Your body starts to decay, and eventually it will turn to dust.
那身体开始衰败腐烂，最终化为尘埃。
So what's the conclusion here?
那这个结论是什么呢
？And verse 8, the teacher says, "Misty, misty."Says the teacher, everything is misty.
在第八节里，传道者说：“虚空的虚空，凡事都是虚空。”
Life is short because death is coming.
生命短暂，因为死亡即将来临。
And if you don't think about death that much right now, but now is the time to ponder about it, because only then we will realize what's truly important in life.
那如果你还不是很关心死亡这件事情的话呢，那现在就是开始思考它的时候，因为只有这样，我们才能意识到生命中真正重要的东西是什么。
Now all it takes is just that one car accident, that one diagnosis of cancer, that loss of a loved one to show just how fleeting, how short is our life.
有时只需要一场车祸，一次癌症确诊。一次亲人的离开，就足以表明我们的生命是多么短暂、模糊和虚空。
And we are moving towards death with every heartbeat, every footstep.
我们的每一次心跳，每一个脚步，其实都是在走向死亡。
We are moving closer to death than perhaps we realize. So be right with God now, while you are still young.
我们可能比自己想象的更接近死亡，所以现在趁你还年轻。
And that's why the teacher's conclusion to the whole book is fear God and keep His commandments.
那这就是为什么传道者对整本书的结论是敬畏神并遵守他的诫命。
And it says in verse 13 to 14, now all has been heard, and here is the conclusion of the matter. Fear God and keep His commandments.For this is the duty of all mankind. For God will bring every deed into judgment, including every hidden thing, whether it is good or evil.
那第十二章十三到十四节已经讲过，这些事都已听见了。总意就是敬畏神，谨守他的诫命，这是人所当尽的本分。因为人所做的事，连一切隐藏的事。
And if you believe that there is a God, then everything matters.
那如果你相信有一位神，那么这一切就变得很重要了。
We will be judged for everything that we do, we say, or we think.
我们会因为我们所做、所说和所想的一切而面对审判。
So we need to fear Him.And keep His commandments.
所以我们需要敬畏他，并遵行他的旨意。
Now, my last talk about fearing God means that we entrust ourselves to Him day by day, and we treat Him as a creator who is different than us.
从上次的讲道当中，我们了解到，敬畏神意味着我们日复一日地将自己交托给他，并将他视为。与我们完全不同的一个至高的造物主。
His commandments throughout the book of Ecclesiastes are to remember Him and be satisfied with what He has given us.
那在整本传道书当中，他的诫命总结起来就是要纪念他，并且满足于他所赐给我们的一切。
So if we truly fear God and obey Him, then we will stop trying to gain.Stop trying to control our future, but instead utterly depend on God for everything.
也就是说，如果我们真正的敬畏神并顺服他，我们就会停止试图抓取世上的好处，停止试图控制我们的未来，而是在一切事物上完全依靠他。
All of our lives are under His eyes.
我们的一生都在他的眼皮底下。
He will bring everything into judgment.
他将审判一切。
There are no secrets with God.
在神面前没有秘密。
If you think you can hide things from your spouse or your boss, well, you can't hide anything from God.
那如果你认为可以向自己的配偶或者是老板来隐藏一些事情的话，那么在神面前我们没有任何事情是可以隐瞒。
There will be accountability for how we live this life.
我们将对我们这一生的生活方式来负责。
Everything matters because there is a God.
那一切都是这个不可小视，因为有一位神在。
So remember Him, fear Him, and know that His judgment is coming.
因此，我们要纪念他，敬畏他，并且知道他的审判即将来临。
The way you live your life under the sun will impact.Your eternity.
你在日光下的生活方式将永久的影响你。
And that's bad news for all of us because we know that we all deserve judgment. We messed up.
那这对我们来说可能是个坏消息，因为我们知道我们都要受到审判，因为我们实在太糟糕了。
None of us can stand the wrath of God when it comes on that last day.
那当神在最后一天到来的时候，我们知道没有人能承受住神的愤怒。
We are all guilty of sin in our thoughts, in our deeds, we fail to love the God who made us. We fail to remember that it is God who gives us life and all things to enjoy in life, and we try to live our lives without reference to Him. Not only death is coming, but eternal death is coming upon all those who have rejected God.
不仅是这个肉体的死亡即将来临，而且是永恒的死也将临到所有拒绝神的人身上。
But there is good news.
但是同时也有一个好消息。
The good news is that even though we are worse than we could ever imagine, but we are more loved than we could ever dream of.
这个好消息就是，尽管我们比想象中的更糟糕，但我们却比想象中的更被爱。
And how does God show that love to us?
神是如何向我们表达这份爱的呢？
John chapter 3 verse 16, a famous one. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
很著名的这一节经文就是约翰福音三章十六节，神爱世人，甚至将他的独生子赐给他们，叫一切信他的不至灭亡，反得永生。
So God showed His love to us by giving us His Son, by sending us His Son to die on the cross so that we don't have to bear His judgment anymore. We have complete forgiveness of sins.
神借着将他的儿子赐给我们，让他的儿子死在十字架上，来向我们表达他的爱，好让我们不必再受审判，罪可以完全赦免。
And not only that, Jesus also defeated death by rising on the third day.
那不仅如此，那耶稣还通过第三天复活来战胜了死亡。
And Paul writes in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 54 to 55, Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting?The sin of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
哥林多前书十五章第五十四到五十五节这样说：经上所记死被得胜吞灭的话就应验了。死啊，你得胜的权势在哪里？死啊，你的毒钩在哪里？死亡的毒钩就是罪，罪的权势就是律法。但感谢神，他透过我们的主耶稣基督使我们得胜。
So death is no longer the end to life.
因此，死亡不再是生命的终点了。
People try to gain the world. They try to secure their future because they know that life is short, and I should just get as much as I can while I'm still young.
人们试图赢得世界。试图确保自己的未来，因为他们知道生命很短暂，应该趁活着的时候，这个得到尽可能多的东西。
They pour out their lives to find satisfaction in money, in their career, in their study, in their relationship, in their status, in their reputation, in their looks, and not realizing that at the end, that these things don't last.
他们倾尽一生在金钱、事业、学位、感情、地位、名誉、外貌中寻找满足感，但却没有意识到这些东西都不会持久。
That satisfaction is anything but momentary.
他们这样的满足只能是短暂的。
And only in Jesus that we can find true satisfaction.Because we know that what we said we have put our trust in Him, our future is secure, our life is secure, and not even death can snatch us out of God's hand because we will have eternal life.
只有在耶稣里，我们才能找到真正的满足，因为我们知道，只要我们相信他，我们的未来就有保障。 我们的生命就有保证，甚至死亡也不能把我们从他手里夺走，因为我们将拥有永生。
We don't need to pour out all of our lives to try and find satisfaction on the temporary things in this world because we know that they don't last.
我们不需要再倾尽一生的去尝试在这个世界上的会朽坏的事物上寻找满足感，因为我们知道它们不会长久。
We can enjoy things in life for what it is. It's just a gift from God.
我们可以享受生活中这些美好事物的本来样子，它们是来自于神的恩赐。
We don't need to fear missing out because death is not the end for us.
我们不需要害怕我们会错过什么，因为死亡不是我们的终点。
There is life after death, and actually we can keep enjoying life and find satisfaction in and with God for eternity.
死后还有生命，事实上我们可以继续享受这个生命，因为它有神陪伴，并且在神里面我们可以找到永恒的满足。
Now life under the sun is temporary, is short, is misty.
日光之下的生命是短暂的，转瞬即逝的，飘渺的。
But life under the sun is eternal.
但在圣子之下的生命却是永恒的。
If you're not a follower of Jesus here today, and if you ever put your trust in Jesus, let me encourage you to make today the day that you turn to Jesus.
如果你还没有选择跟随耶稣，或者还没有相信耶稣，那我鼓励你今天就开始将你的生命转向基督。
You know, you can have a chat with me, or you can chat with the person who brought you. You can chat with your leaders.
你可以来找我谈一谈，或者是跟带你来的人谈一谈，或者是找你的牧者谈一谈。
Just don't delay it any longer.
不要再拖延下去了。
The longer you wait, the easier it is.For you to say no to Jesus, and the harder it is for you to turn around the direction of your life.
事实上，拖的时间越长，你就越容易拒绝耶稣，也就越难扭转你的人生方向。
You will become good at finding satisfaction in the things of the world rather than in Jesus.
你会变得更善于从世界的事物当中。而不是从耶稣里寻找满足。
Death is coming. Don't delay it any longer.
死亡临近了，不要再继续拖延。
And for those of you who have turned to Christ, the command here is the same.
对于那些已经信耶稣的人来说，这里的诫命也是一样的。
Remember your Creator while you are young.
趁你年幼的时候，当纪念造你的主。
Keep practicing thankfulness for all that you have daily.
继续操练对每天所拥有的、所获得的一切表达感恩。
When you wake up each morning, thank God for a new day.
早上醒来的时候，要感谢神给了你新的一天。
When you go to work, thank God for the opportunities to work.
当你去上班的时候。你要感谢神给你这个工作的机会。
When you meet up with your friends, thank God for blessing people in your life.
当你与朋友见面的时候，你要感谢神把他们安排在你的生活当中。
As you keep practicing this thankfulness, you will find that you will enjoy life and be more satisfied because they are really all undeserved gifts from God.
当你不断操练。这种感恩的时候，你就会发现，你能够更享受生活，并且更加满足，因为他们确实是从神而来的，我们本来不配的礼物。
Misty, misty, says the teacher. Everything is misty.
传道者说，虚空的虚空，虚空的虚空，凡事都是虚空。
We can't gain anything from this world. We can't control our time and future. We can't avoid death.Life under the sun is misty, is meaningless, is puzzling, and is dissatisfying.
我们无法从这个世界获得任何东西，我们无法掌控自己的时间和未来， 我们无法避免死亡。日光之下的生命是飘渺的，是毫无意义的，是令人困惑的，也是无法令人满足的。
But in Christ, we have a Creator who has given us all things, who have redeemed us, who have rescued us from death. Life under the sun, under Jesus, is eternal, is meaningful, is purposeful, and is satisfying.
但在基督里，我们有一位恩赐一切的创造者，我们有一位将我们从死亡中拯救出来的救赎主。在圣子之下的生命才是永恒的，有意义的，有目标的，给我们带来满足感。
Let me pray.
一起祷告。
Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are the giver of all things.
天父，我们感谢你，你是恩赐一切的主。
Lord, we acknowledge that sometimes we forget that these things are from you.
我们要承认我们在很多时候都忘记了这些美好的事物是 你的恩赐。
Forgive us and turn our eyes to you once again.
求你赦免我们，帮助我们定睛于你。
And Lord, we do want to pray for those who are here who are considering about you and whether to acknowledge you as the Lord and Savior.
主，我们为在座的还没有信你的人祷告，也许他们还在观望，还在思考你要不要做他们的救主。
We do pray that you continue to help them to find true meaning and purpose in Jesus alone.
求你持续地保守他们，他们在基督里面找到生命的意义。
And for us, we have called you our Father, that you will enable us to live a life of obeying your commandments and fearing you.
对我们这些已经相信你，并且称呼你为阿爸父的所有的人，求你继续的帮助我们，能够纪念你，并且在生活当中遵循你的旨意。
We thank you that death is not the end for us anymore.
我们相信死亡不再是我们生命的终点。
And we look forward to that day where we will see you face to face.
我盼望着在那一天到来的时候，我们可以和你面对面。
In Jesus' name we pray.
我们奉耶稣基督的名。